Welcome class. Today we are checking with the process of reporting, especially we are speaking today about covering speeches and conferences. As we know, most of the contents which we see in newspapers will be the result of some speeches or the statements of the personalities, or the we can call them as the newsmakers and all. So here the speeches are essential part of a reporting, and this is where we get maximum content which flows to the paper. So when it comes to coverage of news, the speeches are essential part, and we should be very careful regarding this coverage aspect. So here there are some preparations required to cover a speech, because you know that we have no control over the speeches, so that we should be very cautious about noting down the points and to report it to the people. So today we'll be looking into the aspects of reporting, especially the speech reporting. So when it comes to speech, it is writing news stories from speeches, meetings and conferences. We know that people communicate with each other in public, but when it comes to speeches, these are usually a one-way process, because we will be having no reaction end here. So the speeches are delivered, and a reporter can only note down the points and he can take it to the readers by making a report of that. So meetings and conferences usually involve communication between the individuals taking part. In covering speech, journalists are generally part of the audience. Definitely we will be sitting in the conference and will be covering whatever being told on the dais or the stage. But when it comes to meetings and conferences, again a journalist will be a part of the audience, but sometimes it will be like he'll be the only person, or the he'll be the one and only audience to witness the happening. When it comes to meeting, we can consider like the meetings of councils or the committees. Here journalists may find themselves as the only member of the audience. So we have to look into the challenges a reporter will have to face at the time of covering a speech. So unlike interview, here a reporter has no control over the session. He'll be a silent spectator, and he can't take the subject under his control, or he can't direct the content of the subject by asking question. In interview, we know that we can guide the topic by asking question, but that cannot be possible when it comes to a speech coverage. At speeches, speakers themselves decide what to speak. So the only option will be left to the reporter is to cover the content. Here the journalist has to listen to what is being said, and selecting the important parts of the speech and making notes will be definitely a challenge in case we have multiple speakers and we have vivid content to discuss. It may seem that a journalist has no control, still he can follow few steps to get the information of his choice, definitely by covering the part of speech which he find important for his audience. So let's concentrate on essentials of speech reporting. So here the ability to recognize the most newsworthy aspects of a story becomes one of the essential part here, or we can call it as the key skill which a reporter who is deputed to cover the news need to possess. To select key points from a mass information, and to note down the content which is being said, because we know that we have no control over the speed of the narration as well. So we need to be little fast enough to noting down the point. Definitely today we have digital technologies where we can record the entire speech, and we can listen it again and note down the important point, but it is not advisable, because you know that in case the speech goes around 1 or 2 hours, again you have to sit back in the office for the same hour and to listen the content. So we don't advise this particular method. Instead, you can note down the points, but still you can record the content digitally for sake of verification. In case you get some doubt regarding the point which you have already taken or noted down, you can definitely listen to the content which you have recorded and can verify it. So we can consider this as the essential, and a confident approach to new people and a new situation definitely finds one of the key aspect here, because you know that when we find a person who is speaking, we should be able to judge his idea and what he's concentrating upon, so that that has to be identified immediately, and ability to compress many thousands of words into clear, concise and accurate news story is another essential here, because you know that we can't report each and everything which is being told to the audience, so that we have to pick the important element of the content and you have to give it to the readers. So it is just like summarizing the entire speech into few sentences or a news report, so that that will be directed to the people later. So there are two aspects to report on any speech or meeting which you have to concentrate. The first one is setting of the event. So whenever it comes to speech reporting, elaborating the setting of the event is one of the essential, and the second one is the content of speeches. So the setting of the event and content of speech, both has to be reported to the audience, so that by reading your news story they should get the clear idea about the event. Okay, this is how it happened, or this is the method, or these are the contents which are told to the audience over the speeches or the conferences. So this has to be clearly mentioned to the readers of your report. So you have to cover both setting of the event and content of speeches in your report. Let's concentrate on the setting aspect first. So when it comes to setting, a reporter should make records of the event very clearly to their readers, because a reader should understand the mood or the atmosphere of that event by the words which you have given to them. So that visual description need to be there in your report, so that the readers will get the exact idea or the mood of the atmosphere or the event, and the estimation of the size of group or the people who are part of that event. Maybe it is like the rallies or the protest. In these situations, the number matters. How many people participated in that one, that really matters. So we have to give that kind of estimation to the audience, so that they will get to know about the vastness of the event. A reporter may get a better estimate by moving around as at a protest march or rally. So definitely they can march around at the time of rally, and they can go with the group, so that they will get to know the ground realities or the ground pictures, so that they can easily communicate that event details to their readers later. The event organizers might be able to help some time to get the exact number, but we can't rely upon the organizers every time, so we have to have our basic data set. In some very organized events, you might get a clue from the number of plates served at the meal. So this is another method to get to know the exact number of the people, and you should also report audience reaction if they are significant. So this is about setting of mood to be revealed to the audience. So by following these factors, you can definitely convey the idea of the event to your readers. So the next part is the content. The content part of the speech, we'll be discussing that in the next lecture of ours. Thank you.